Okay, so I'm gonna explain how to remove the governor, the speed engine governor, on I think it's 1996 and below club car DS golf carts. So I'll tell you step by step. So first thing, there's this long coat hanger looking like rod. This is what attaches to the governor to the throttle. Normally, the governor would sit right there, like if my phone can pick it up. It's this little nub, pretty much, where this governor arm sits on. And once the drive gear and the transmission reaches a certain speed, it's going to throw some magnets, and those magnets that are spinning around in a circular gear are going to pull this arm back, which pulls this governor rod, closing the throttle. So first thing you want to do is remove the cover plate covering the throttle linkage. It's this thing right here. Normally it would sit right here covering everything up. You want to take that off and take a minute to study all your internal components. So ignore this spring right here. I'll get to this later. So here's your throttle right here. So that's wide open, that's closed. As you see, there's a cable down there, there's your arm, and there's the actual butterfly right there. So where this comes into play is this hooks to the bottom right there on the throttle, and that will pull back to close it. Now it's actually very, very simple to remove the governor. So now I'm going to show you the steps on how to do it. First, at the end of the governor arm, you'll see this little swivel-like tensioner thing here. And the end of this, I actually bent it, but it would normally slide through, and that's where you can adjust how much your throttle opens. But normally you would think, well, why don't I just adjust it so it just opens the throttle more? Well, because the more you adjust it for more throttle, the less, pretty much more fat, more speed, larger throttle on the top end. But on the low end, once you hit the gas, it's already going to be at like half throttle. So you're not going to, you're pretty much high speed only. Like half open, the wide open throttle all the time. And that's the only way to get any more speed. So there's a little bolt sitting right on top here and one through the center. Nut and bolt. You want to unscrew that and then loosen up the bolt that's holding this on. And then it actually does not pop off, but it slides out. It'll slide out this way off the pivot. So once you successfully gotten the control arm off, you go up to your linkage. Now, where the rod is holding the throttle, there'll be these two little clips on the top right here and on the bottom. You get a little needle nose and take off these clips that hold the throttle rod on. And also, so it'll pop up. It'll be sticking up this way. So you pop it up, and once it's just these two clips, no nuts or anything. Just pop it up and just slide it out of this whole guard here. Now, where this spring comes into place, this does not have, this car does not come with a throttle spring. So if I didn't have the spring here, there would not be any tension on the throttle, and it would be wide open all the time. So that spring actually went to the governor. You can see there's the hole where it came through. And there's a little, I don't think you could see it. There's a mount right down here where that would go through. Take that spring. I'm gonna hook it through the same little hole that's on one of the control arms for the throttle. And hook it into the linkage plate bolt. So this way, you got full throttle and full travel too. So then, to make sure everything works, I actually haven't tested this yet. So most of you don't know this, but here's you cannot start the club car in neutral because these little tabs. Hold this tab up and you hit the gas, and that'll start it. And also, make sure it's in neutral because you don't want this thing taken off. So hold that up. It's a cold start, by the way. All right, started. All right, I'm gonna let this thing warm up a bit, and then I'll show you how it works. Okay, so I got this thing warmed up now. Now I'll show you how the whole throttle system works. So of course it's a neutral, hold up on this tab. You can see it working. I'm not going to hold it wide open for too long because it's still kind of cold. And but pretty much, that's how you remove your governor. And it's reversible. All you need to do is, of course, I'd have to straighten out this rod, just piece everything back together, put those little clamps back on. So if you ever want it governed again, just piece it back together and everything. And also, these club cars, they do have electronic rev limiters. I'm not sure how effective they are, but supposedly they rev the RPM, but still, this particular golf cart's a flathead, so I wouldn't leave it open more than a couple of 10 seconds or so, or else, you don't want to throw a rod. I also recommend getting a tachometer, which I bought, just so you can monitor the RPMs. These engines redline at about 4,300 RPM, and when cruising, that's a stock 14 mile an hour speed with the governor, about 3,100 RPM. And get a tach. I'd recommend it. Make sure you don't hold it open too long over 4,300 RPM. But yeah, thanks for watching. That's how you remove your governor on any club car, I think 1996 and below. Thanks for watching.